Hey guys, this is the part 4 of Introduction to R, and in this part we will see how to get into the website of R, which is free. We have to go to www.rproject.org. You have to write like r-project.org, hit enter. Yeah. This might look a bit small. Okay, I'm using Mozilla, so I'm pressing Control plus plus to make it large so that you can see it conveniently. So if you want to download R, go to CRAN under download, and there are lots of mirror. Just go whichever mirror is close to you and then download, say, for whatever system you want to use, and the base package. And this is the thing that you should be downloading, and save as wherever you want to save, maybe in desktop. Yeah, so you are downloading R currently. Yeah, I have downloaded it already, so I'm going to cancel it. But this is how you download it. So if you want to download the packages, you can go to Windows Contribution, and here are the package. But the packages are for several versions, and the version that we have been downloading, it was 2.6, so we'll go to the package for 2.6, and here are the packages for 2.6. Lots of package, like however you want to download. You can download it in the local files like this. You can go to R. Okay, then go to packages, install packages from local zip files. Then from the local zip files, wherever you have downloaded it, you can install the package, or you could set CRAN mirror at first. Say I'm setting it at Canada. Then once you have set the mirror, then install packages. Like it is going to install packages right now. Like whatever package you want to install, just select it. Or if you want to install it all, just select the first one, press shift, and the last one, and okay, it will install everything. Yeah, I just don't want to install everything. I think it's a very good idea to install whatever you need, not the whole thing. So yeah, this is how we install the packages. Yeah, in our site, this is a very good source of help, and you can get all sort of documents. For example, for documents, you can search for the manuals, whatever manuals are there, and you'll see an introduction to R. This is the best book ever I have read for the introductory R, and you can browse the HTML, see the content, and go wherever you want, or you could download the PDF and see what is in the PDF. Yeah, this is the PDF, just in case if you want to download the whole book and print it and read it that way. Yeah, and also there is a FAQ. You can go to rfaq to know what sort of problems people usually have and what you need to know, and this sort of stuff. So in our webpage, we can get a lot of documentations, and also not to mention the contributed documents as well. Like if you want to see the English contributed documents, there are a lot of documents for graphics, simpler. Yeah, this is a good one. And a lot of good books are there to read, and these are very, very helpful for various sort of audience. You can just know nothing and go through these books, and you'll know everything there is to be known. Are for beginners, yeah, these are all good books. You can go through these books and get to know about a lot of things in R. Yeah, not only in introductory R, also they cover some of the advanced topics. If you just go to documents contributed, you will get this sort of help. And if you want to post some of your views or your problems, you can try to go to their site where you can interact with our community. So let's suppose you want to email them about some particular issue you want to discuss with the R community. Just go to R project and then go to mailing list, and yeah, there is different sort of R mailing list. You might want to go to R help. Before posting any emails in R help, go to posting guide, read it thoroughly. And once you are done with it, go back and see the web interface where all the help files are there. And yeah, you have read the general instructions, so you should be able to go to the R help archive. Yeah, this is the help archive for every day. So by date, you can see all the messages that are being posted in R, and go back. And there is a full R site that is searchable. Yeah, you can search whatever you need, and you might just get lucky and find it. Suppose you want to find something about moments in some package. Yeah, and it will show you the mails that were related to moments, and you could just go through them and try to figure out whether that solves your problems or not. Yeah, I think it is a very good idea to go through the mailing list at first, before you post anything, and try to search whatever your question is. And if you don't get anything related to that, then read the posting guide and email the R community. Yeah, they are very, very helpful, like most of the good guys are there. So this is about it. This is the part 4 of Introduction to R. Hope you enjoyed it.